गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, वी आर फ्रॉम टीम 13 एंड द टीम मेंबर्स आर दासिर मधु, मुस्कान श्रीवास्तव, सचिन राउत एंड उत्कल प्रसाद, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्पीक अबाउट बी प्लान एंड मार्केट रिसर्च विच वी मेड ऑन बिहेवियर ऑफ कंज्यूमर बेस्ड ऑन दैट फिश प्रोडक्शन. ओके, एंड द लोगो डिपिक्स एंटायर व्हाट प्रोसेस एक्जैक्टली वी आर डूइंग. सो इट इज लाइक कैचिंग द फिश बाय द फार्मर्स. वी विल बी सपोर्टिंग द फार्मर्स इन द कैपिटल एंड विल बी गेटिंग द प्रोक्यूरिंग द फिश फ्रॉम देम एंड विल बी डिलीवरिंग टू द कंज्यूमर्स सो दैट we are it is like a bilateral mutual and our tagline is one magical ship for happy meal. So the thing is that we will be shipping exactly to the plate of the consumer so that there is no sort of unhygiene practices that are occurring in locals. Next, so the table of contents depicts that what exactly we are speaking today. So it will start with business overview and ends where implementation conclusion. We'll be speaking about our marketing strategies, core values, and financial projections. And I'll take the lead to start with business overview. Yeah, we are team 4 from Manage. We got complete our Manage PGDM ABM course in 2018. So we are going to start a startup on fish production and by linking both farmers and consumers. So our team members are 4, as I already mentioned. So the idea came from the brains of Sachin Rathore and Dasari Madhu. So we proposed this business plan. And the thing is that the team is well equipped with knowledge with various aspects like supply chain management, financials, procurement, and human resource. And when we see the Indian scenario, India stands at 96 lakh million tons in the fish production, but when we see that in global perspective, it was only the 5%. And Andhra Pradesh state, which ranks first in the fish production from several years, like from 25 years. So our target market is Andhra Pradesh, where there is a good sort of opportunities for both consumers point and as per business point of view. So this data tells that how much opportunities we are getting from Andhra Pradesh and from India. So among the total production, India stands only 5%, where the total contribution of the world. And in that 96%, 16 lakh million tons is from only Andhra Pradesh. That is completely from inland water bodies. Inland water bodies are those where the fish production is away from the marine and it's totally care taken by the farmers in his own land. And the market analysis based on the current situation depicts that in India, as far as CGPR is concerned, it is increasing day by day. And currently it is doubling a lot, like 10.2 is a CGPR. And by 2024, the production is going to double. So it is a great opportunity for fishery sector where we can boost the end lot of opportunities. And when we see the per capita consumption of the fish in 2001, it was like just 9 kg per person. But when we see the 2018 scenario, it was like double, like 18 kg per person. The per capita income depicts that how much the person is consuming with respect to the fish. And our target market is Andhra Pradesh. The thing is that why we choose Andhra Pradesh, it was like it is having like 900 kilometers of coastal line, which provides a lot of opportunities for the fishery sector. And the why we choose only four districts is that Visakhapatnam, Vijayawada, Nellore and Chittoor is that these cities are highly urban cities and it is a newly formed state. And we are having like a lot of opportunities where the consumers are high in demand. And this pandemic created a situation where the consumer are more health conscious so that there is a good demand for the people and fishery sector. And in these cities, there is good opportunities where the IT sector is increasing and it is a chance for more nuclear families. So that there is number of combined families are decreasing, so individuals are preferring an individual family, so the customs of changing the consumption behavior. And meanwhile, the thing is that previous days they used to consume only on Sundays as a occasion of consumption of non-veg, but the scenario is completely changed. They are preferring the day what they exactly like. So and Andhra Pradesh is a state where it provide n lot of opportunities for different sort of varieties of fish, starting from tilapia to murrel and katla to rohu. So it provides a various taste for the consumers. And when we see the competitors of Andhra Pradesh, these are the major competitors like Apex Frozen Foods, where it is only concentrated on the exports rather than local market. And even Coastal Corporation is more concentrated on the world scenario rather than focusing on the domestic. And these are the leading exporters in India. And not only exporters, but also these are the things that provides samplings or seedlings to the farmers. but at a premium rate. So the thing is, the farmers are getting the seedlings from these particular corporates at a high price. But what we will be doing, like, we'll be interlinking the scientist, marine scientist, with the farmers, so that they'll be procuring the seeds at a premium quality at a lower prices. So we'll be benefiting the farmers at this point. And when we see the other two bigger corporates who are engaged in fish production, fish exports, are Devi Fisheries, Ananda Fisheries. And one with respect to Devi Fisheries, it was going with broad range of fish products, ranging from crabs, shrimps, fish, and value-added products with respect to ready-to-eat canned foods in fish. And when we see the Ananda Group, it was a company from Bhimavaram, which is in Andhra Pradesh, but it was covering entire Andhra Pradesh, and it was compiled of various agri products related to rice, poultry, fish, shrimps. So the thing is that most of these companies are more focused on exports, but neglecting the point of domestic use. So our company makes a chance over this, so that we are targeting more domestic view, so that these corporates cannot be our competitors at all. So we'll be targeting on the domestic view, and our project is for more only for those four districts. And meanwhile, when the projections are concerned, like, by 2022 we'll be covering entire state of Andhra Pradesh. By 2024 we'll be covering like 3 to 4 states of India. So our market research will be taken care by Sachin Rathod. So that's it from my side. If you are having any doubts, you can ask me.
Good job. Good job. Great work. Half the time is already over. So, guys, go ahead.
Okay. I will take on the marketing research. Next slide, sir. Okay. To know about the consumer preference for the fish product in our targeted area and the problems related to that, we have deployed a survey form to know the consumer preference. And here are the responses we have received from them. Over the likes and dislike for the fish in the targeted area, we have received like 90% of the people in the area like to consume fish. And this gives a fish basket an upper hand as we are targeting the fishery sector. And we can grow in that area in a faster pace. And for the second one, consumer preference over the fish cut, like in the fishery sector, while researching over it, we came across there will be a specific cuts for each kind of fish, such as curry cut, Bengal cut, and fillet cut. So in our survey, we found that 80% of the people prefer curry cut, and 12.9% of the customers prefer Bengali cut, and 7.1% prefer the fillet cut. And over the consumer preference among the fresh meat and the refrigerated fish, around 69.2% of people preferred to consume live fish or the freshly cut fish. None of the consumer prefer to go with the refrigerated fish. So here, fish basket takes this as the opportunity, as we are totally committed to supply the fresh fish product to the market on the daily demand basis. Next slide, sir.
Great.
Madhu, next slide.
Yeah. Keep going quickly.
Sachin, you can see it, right? Sachin, can you see this?
Yes.
Madhu, you got stuck.
Sachin, maybe you try without video.
Sir, can we take Sachin Pate last so that
Yeah.
we can carry on?
Okay. Okay, sure.
Muskan, you can take.
I really appreciate some of the team members, they are reminding you of the time. They're so nice of them. So great, guys. See, only 5 minutes left, so please rush.
Muskan, you
Yes,
can
sir.
take it here.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Muskan Srivastav, and now I'm going to talk about the principles of our company. Next slide, Madhu sir. Okay, so talking about the mission statement of our company, we have got a GRAPE approach where G stands for grow and develop into a market leader. R stands for reduce the wastage of fish processing to a minimum. A is achieve high level of client satisfaction. P is to produce an end product of highest quality. And E is to establish long-lasting partnership with regulating authorities, suppliers, employees, and customers. Next slide, sir. Okay, so now talking about the core values of the company. First and foremost thing for us is customer service. So first core value is customer service excellence. Second is the teamwork. And third is integrity. Fourth, we are focusing on the continuous improvement and innovation of our company. Fifth is we want to hire best people at work. Next, sir. Okay, talking about the objectives. So we have got short-term and long-term objectives. The short-term objectives include building a strong customer base, focusing on our target market, and to generate ample revenue for the company and make decent profits in the initial years. Second is to maximize the productivity of the farms by enhancing the availability of technology and equipment to the farmers, and also to make them aware of the use of these technologies for cultivation so that with our improvement, we can focus on their improvement too. Third one is focusing on promoting the sustainability of the business and strengthening the company by analyzing the competition, and we want to improve consistently in the domain also by focusing on what are the strengths and weaknesses of our competitors and how we can overcome our weaknesses in the market. Fourth one is creating a reliable digital platform for the delivery of our products so that the penetration of our products is increased. Long-term objectives, in the long run, we want to grow our consumer base and target new groups of consumers. And also we want to expand our business from outside the above mentioned districts of Visakhapatnam, Nellore, Chittor and Vijayawada. Second one is to expand the product portfolio by adding new products based on the demands of the consumers. Third one is collaborating with the international market leaders operating in the same sector, as we want to increase our domain from exporting within the states to exporting to different countries. Fourth one is focus on development of R&D facilities for staying up to date with the latest technologies and changing consumer trends so that our products remain viable in the market. Next one, Madhu sir.
Two more minutes, so please.
So our marketing strategies include six aspects. First one is market segmentation, where we will segment our target consumers and focus on them. Second one is the unique selling proposition, where we will deliver the nutritious and hygienic product to the consumers. Third is marketing channels, where we want to deliver products in the local markets of the four districts we have already mentioned. Fourth one is promotion and advertising. In order to promote our business, we would like to focus on social media campaigns and word of mouth marketing. Fifth one is supporting our customers. We will provide discounts to the customers and also check for any feedback from them so that we can continuously improve and check our loopholes. Sixth one is evaluating the success. We want to regularly check how we are functioning in the market and also analyze the competitors. So talking about the SWOT analysis, here the strengths lie in the healthy relationships with fish growers. We want to have healthy relationships with fish growers that will contribute to our company. Then second one is the latest processing equipment, which we will include in our company. And then third is contact with the fish feed producers so that we are able to sustain in the market. And talking about the weaknesses, as we are a startup and a new player in the fish and meat processing segment, we will be facing a high competition during the initial days. Third one, like talking about the opportunities, as Madhu has already discussed, that there is an increase in per capita consumption of fish. So that is something where we find our opportunity. And then hotels and fast food restaurants, we will also collaborate with them so that we can deliver our products to the consumers. Then threats, talking about the pandemic situations like COVID-19, where some supply chain disruptions were there because of the national lockdown. So that is something as a threat. Then we have bad weather and natural disasters, which, for example, cyclones, which occur in Andhra Pradesh. So that will contribute to the threat. And then unfavorable government policies also contribute. And then arrival of a competitor is always a threat for any startup. So that is common for us. Next slide, please. Okay, from here, I would like Utkal to continue. Thank you.
Sajin, you complete your part
first. Okay, I will complete. Madhu sir, you take to my slides. I'm so sorry, sir, and batchmates. I got disconnected.
Sir, you are not audible, sir.
I'm not audible.
Sir,
you are audible. You are audible.
Right. Thank you. But how much time more you would be requiring your time?
Only 2 minutes for mine, sir. I will complete it.
Okay, then I think, but the business plan is yet to be presented, right?
Yes, sir. That will be presented. And I will just complete within 1 minute, sir.
Please, all the best, Sachin. Go ahead.
Okay. During our marketing research, we have floated a questionnaire about consumer preference for the protein. And what we found was majority of the consumer were preferring fish, chicken and meat for their sources of protein. And 14.3% were preferring only fish for their source of protein. Wow. And about the frequency of the fish consumption, majority of the consumers, what we have got consumed once in a week. And 35.6% consumed only on the special occasions. And consumer feedback over the price, what we have got is majority of the consumer purchase the fish at the rate of 150 to 200 per kg. And we take this opportunity in the fish basket. And we are ranging the price between 150 to 200. Next slide, sir. Madhu, next slide. Okay, what are all the conclusion which we have derived from the marketing research, which we are going to implement in our startup is about 63% of the consumers regularly are involved in regular consumption of fish and meat, and 99% of them are unable to trace from where the fish they are consuming are taken from. Because for the last few years, there has been certain cases which has been registered, like fishes have been cultivated in a polluted water and they are given with some supplements and the antibiotics, which are usually harmful for the human consumption. So we take a chance here and we will ensure that there will be fishes will be grown only on the natural basis and there will be no supplement, no antibiotics and will be grown in a pure water. And 70% of the people, they prefer fresh fish. So we take this as an opportunity and we will be supplying the fresh fish to the market on the daily basis and on basis on the daily demand of the market. Next slide, sir.
Thank you.
Madhu, sir, next slide. Okay, this is the plan and this is how we will be working. So from the farmers, we will be procuring the fish at a remunerative price and we will be also giving them the fingerlings and the feeds and all the necessary technical knowledge what they have required for the growth of the fishes. And from after procuring from them, we will take into our processing industry and we will clean them, we will pack them and we will cut them and pack them. And after that, it will be sent to the customer market. And even we have a customer outlet for sale and to supply and also a supply to a nearby market. And we have also planned to do a home delivery through a WhatsApp business connection. And by this way, we want to provide our consumers with the best quality of fish and nutritious product. Thank Next you. Slide, sir. Madhu, next slide. Okay. This is our product overview. Majorly, we are now concentrating on the four kinds of fish, that is Rohu, Katla, Mahasir, and Magur. And the preferred cut, what we are doing in our industry is curry cut, fillet cut, and the Bengali cut. And we are packing the products in an aseptic packaging with no preservatives are added, as we are totally health conscious of our customers, and we are also including a QR code traceability so that the consumer know from where the product has come. Next slide, sir. Okay, these are the portfolio of our products, which include Rohu fish, Rohu large with curry cut, Rohu medium Bengal cut, Katla fish curry cut, Magur fish, Tilapia fillet cut, and Murale Kore Minu. And here are the price which are mentioned in the below. And thank you, sir.
Okay, great job. Wow, that's good.
Kal sir, mute me up.
Yeah, yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. I will talk about the management plan. Next slide, please. Okay, here is our team. Our team consists of four managers. Founder Muskan Srivastava, he is also the executive officer, and co-founder Vice President HR is me, and co-founder Chief Operating Officer Madhu, and Chief Marketing Officer Sachin Rathod. These are the four people who are taking care of this business, and this is our organizational chart. Muskan is leading the team, and Vice President, Chief Marketing Officer, these all are dealing with their respective segments, and we will be hiring people from the four districts which we are operating, and we'll be taking them and training them according to our business. Okay, next please.
Right.
Now for the financial plan, let's come to the financial plan. Here in 2022 we are going to start up, so our land and site development we are taking it as 6 lakh, and building will be investing 25 lakh, for plant and machinery 45.75, for motor vehicles we will not purchase them, we'll take it in rent, as we are investing 8 lakhs. For office automation equipments, because it is now digitally, all things are digital, so we are investing a lot, like nearly 15 lakh. For technical know-how and fees expenses, these things we will be taking care of 5 lakh. Preliminary and pre-operative expenses, we are investing 1.5 lakh. For contingency, because like this pandemic, if something has happened, then we'll keeping it as 7.7 lakh. And for working capital, we are keeping 10.15 lakh. So together we are investing 123.50 lakh. So this we are required for startup our business. And for 2021, we are predicting that we will be getting investment of 20 lakh, which will be in 2022, 24.5 lakh and 29 lakh and 33 lakh. This will be our, means we are objective of predicted the growth like this from 2024, 29, 33. Next slide, please. Yeah, implementation and customer. The major challenges means faced by the farmers and the consumers that we are solving is, earlier fishermen, they have to give due to commission agent, then to vendor, then to consumer. So we are removing these two factors, the commission agent and the vendors, because of them which they are means the consumer are buying it a higher price, and that is of not hygienic. So we are dealing with these two problems and solving it by our startup fish basket, where we are providing fresh fish along with the premium quality, and about hygienic, there will be no question about that.
Great.
Next slide.
Good job.
You can see, right?
This is the last slide in which I'm going to take about what are the benefits from our startup. We'll get the benefit. First of all, the farmers. It will help the farmers because we are providing them all the credentials, like we are providing seed, capital along with the feeds also. So they can grow the fish in a better condition, in organic condition. And second one is the paying farmer the remunerative price, which they must get. Because of other things, they are not getting at that time, but now they are getting it. Next is, we are providing 24/7 credit farmer, because farmers, even if they will face some problems, they can contact us 24/7. If they have problem in any part, like seeding, capital or anything, we'll be providing them because they are our clients. And delivery process fish directly into the menu of the consumer. Like, if it is our WhatsApp business, we are starting delivery. That like, if somebody is needed, they can contact us through WhatsApp, and we can deliver them as fast as we can. And for the traceability, for which it is a long discussion has been going on. So we are providing with QR code so that they can trace that whether this fish is fresh or in premium quality or not, or from where it is, it has been grown or where it has been taken. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Team 13, Madhu, Sachin, Muskan, and Utkal. Good job. There's so much of appreciation for you.